On behalf of Postgraduate Department of Zoology, on this e-workshop and invited talk on the topic lab culture, I cordially welcome worthy Dr. A. Monasundaram, who is a visionary and dynamic scientist,
Indian Institute of Natural Resins and Gums, ICAR, at Ranchi, Jharkhand. He is presently working in the field of collection and conservation of lac insect genetic resources, lac insect crop management, and lac insect pest management, and has reached unprecedented heights in this field. Dr. Mohanasundaram has a number of publications in journals of national and international repute. He has authored 2 books, 3 book chapters, 5 technical bulletins, and 1 training manual. He has conducted 21 seminars, symposiums, and training programs. He has also received Distinguished Workers Award for the year 2018 and has also received Young and Outstanding Scientist Award. The list of Dr. Mohanasundaram's achievements is never-ending. So now I invite esteemed Dr. Mohanasundaram
to enlighten us with his talk. Sir, over to you.
अर्चना मैम,
यस सर,
हैव यू रिसीव्ड माय पीपीटी?
या वी कैन, वी आर एबल टू सी योर स्क्रीन सर.
ओके,
बट यू हैव नॉट ओपन्ड योर पीपीटी.
1 मिनट. Is it visible now?
No, it's not opened yet.
No, I have opened, ma'am.
Okay, so it'll take little time.
Okay.
You need to share your screen again, sir. Now your screen is not visible. Yeah, now it's there.
Not visible.
Yeah, it's there, sir. Now we can visualize the PPT.
Yes, sir, you can start now.
Now it's visible, ma'am?
Yeah, now it's visible.
Okay. Shall I start, ma'am?
Yes, sure, sir.
Okay. Actually, respected Sadhana ma'am, head of the department, Kanya Mahavidyalaya, Jalandhar. Actually, thank you very much, ma'am, to giving this opportunity to me to deliver that about lac culture, e-workshop on lac culture. At our level best, I have displayed here. I will show one by one. I can give demo later on. Myself, Dr. A. Mohanasundaram, working as a scientist in lac production division since 2010. Actually, today's presentation, this is the outline of today's presentation. I will be telling about what is the lac and its composition, followed by life cycle and crop cycle of lac insect, Then what are the lac cultivation operations? How we can culture the lac insect? Then where are the lac growing areas in India? How there some of the species already extinct? Those detail also I will be telling. Then merits of lac production as well as lac resin I will be covering. Then nowadays we are also introducing lac with other agriculture crop or horticulture crop, lac integrated agroforestry system. I will be briefing about lac integrated agroforestry system. Then what all the industries are working based on lac. Finally, that forward and backward linkage in marketing of lac. Then how farmers are marketing lac, how that industry people are getting, those linkages also I will be telling. These are all the outline of my presentation. Lac, nothing but there is a secretory product from an insect. Their entire body, it will be mostly it will secrete for its own protection, but we are using our purpose. For rearing of lac insect, we need some of the host tree. It won't come all the tree species. A specific tree it needs. Lac, there is a subsidiary source of income, mainly tribal people. Here, Jharkhand, Chhattisgarh, Odisha, West Bengal, this area, tribals are cultivating lac very, very beginning. India is the leading lac producing country in the world, followed by Thailand, Indonesia. Some of the minor quantity of lac produced from by China, Myanmar, and Cambodia. Actually, Jharkhand, the state is first rank, followed by Chhattisgarh, Madhya Pradesh, West Bengal, Maharashtra. These five states, you can see here, around 96% lac produced from the this five state only. You can see that by chart. Here around 56% lac produced from the Jharkhand, 17% from Chhattisgarh, 13% from Madhya Pradesh, around 6% from West Bengal, then Maharashtra 5%. Then remaining things are very meager, Odisha 3%, other states are only 0.3, 0.1, 0.06, 0.05%. These are all the state-wise contribution in lac production in India. Then mostly lac production, major lac production takes place in Jharkhand, but major lac processing center, it is there in West Bengal. In total, 155 processing units is there. Out of 155, around 102 processing units there in West Bengal, 29 in Chhattisgarh, 16 in Jharkhand. Then Maharashtra, Madhya Pradesh also, we are having lac processing unit. Then lac, there is an export-oriented commodity. You can see in 2017-18, around 226 crore earned from the export of lac byproduct like shellac, aldehydic acid, and seed lac. Then top importing country, USA around 25%. They are exporting from India. Then Switzerland, Germany, Pakistan, these are all the country. They are importing lac from the from India. Then what are the important constituents of lac? Lac, it contains three things. Majorly resin, that is 68% resin, then 1% dye, 6% wax. Remaining things are some impurities there. You can see the photograph here. This is a resin, stick lac. From the stick lac, seed lac will come. From seed lac, shellac will come. This is the resin portion. While washing the stick lac, we will be getting the lac dye. That what through mostly we used to wash through water. That water we used to collect the lac dye. If 1% lac dye is available, then lac wax 6% is there. These are all the important constitution of lac. Then this is a systematic position of lac. Lac insect, it will come under the class Insecta, subclass Terricota. The division is Hemimetabola, and the order Hemiptera, the family Tachardidae, tribe Tachardini, subtribe Tachardi. Lac, it will come under the genus Keria and species Laca. You can see here the lac insect, it is a Keria Laca under the family Tachardidae and the order order Hemiptera. Lac insect are soft body in nature, mostly that I think you might be seen some aphid, mealybug. These are the scale insect. These are the coccid group. Lac insect also, it will come under the coccid group. It has two genera. one is Keria, another one is Paratacadina. That's two genera. Around 26 species of lac insect reported from the world. Actually, lac, there is a natural resin secreted by the lac insect, which thrives only on tender twigs of some specific tree. I already told initially, it needs some specific tree. It won't come all the tree. The lac insect has two strains. One is Rangini, another one is Kusumi. Each strain having the two crops each. For example, Rangini strain having both summer crop as well as rainy season crop. Summer crop we locally call it as Baisakhi crop. Actually, depend upon the harvesting time, and they have given the name. In rainy season crop, we can locally call it as Katki. Similarly, Kusumi strain also having two crops. One is winter crop, another one is summer crop. Winter crop, we can call it as Agani. Summer crop, we can call it as Jatvi. Here, Rangini strain, we can cultivate on Palas. Palas, that is Butia monosperma, but we cannot cultivate on Kusum. If we cultivate also, we won't get much lac, very meager amount of lac we will get. Similarly, Kusumi strain lac insect, we can cultivate on Kusum, but we cannot cultivate on Palas. This is a major difference between the Rangini strain and Kusumi strain. But in case of Bear and Calindra calothuris, the new bushy host plant, we can cultivate both the strain of lac insect on Jujubus mauritiana and Calindra calothuris. Then another one bushy host is there. We can cultivate both Rangini as well as Kusumi, but we will be getting more yield on Kusumi strain. This is bivoltine nature. It means we can cultivate two crops per year. Another one species is there. That is Keria sarada. It is a trivoltine lac insect. We can harvest lac insect thrice a year. Mostly this Keria sarada found in coastal area of Odisha, West Bengal. It matures thrice a year, like March, April, then June, July, then October, November. This is some of the basic about lac. Lac insect also having three color. One is crimson color, like reddish color. I have shown the dye, that is a crimson color. Then second one is a yellow color lac insect. Then third one is cream color. Mostly farmers, they used to cultivate, they used to have the crimson color lac insect. Anything else, ma'am? Hello? Am I audible?
Yes, sir, you are audible.
Yes, sir, you can continue.
Actually, three different color is there. You can see the crimson color, yellow color, and cream color. Mostly farmers, they used to cultivate crimson color lac insect. Some area, it is mixed population of crimson as well as yellow. In case of Jabalpur, Chhattisgarh area, we will be getting mixed population. In case of Rajasthan area, Punjab, Rajasthan, we used to get yellow color population. But we are also having white cream color lac insect also, but it is in experimental stage. In our gene bank, we are maintaining. Then life cycle of lac insect, actually, you are all the geology student. You might be knowing in the hemimetabola, holometabola. The lac insect, mostly it will come under the order Hemiptera, that is Hemimetabola. Mostly Hemipteran order, it is having the three stages. One is egg, after that nymphal stage, then adult stage. Similarly, lac insect also having three stages. But here, we won't unable to see the egg stage. Here, the lac insect mostly ovoviviparity nature. Immediately after egg laying, we will be getting young ones. That is the nature of lac insect. We are unable to see eggs on the naked eye. It will be there inside the mother cell. We will be able to see only crawler. That's why I am showing the crawler. You can see this picture. This is hand drawing diagram of lac insect crawler. Lac insect crawler is having that pair of antennae, then pair of ocelli, then three pairs of leg. Then you can see the ventral side, the spiracle is there for respiration. Then caudal filament is there. This is the hand drawing diagram. You can see that corner, this microscopic picture. Under the microscope, we can able to see the lac insect, all the, this is antennae, then pairs of leg, then you can see caudal filament is there here. Okay, under the microscope only we can able to see the all these stages. Lac inside mostly it molt thrice. It is having three instar. Actually, after some time, that lac inside, initially we won't differentiate which one is male inside, which one is female inside. For each crop, after a particular period, you can say half of the crop, that male female sexual dimorphism it will be happening. Here, in case of male, after first molting. Both male as well as female, it lose the all the appendages. Whatever I told in crawler, it contains legs, antennae, eye. These are all the appendages. But after the first molt, particularly in male, it loses the all the appendages. And then during second molt onwards, the sexual dimorphism is pronounced. We can able to see that male female sexual dimorphism from third instar onwards. We can able to see very clearly. We can see that picture here. This is male. This is female. I will be telling in second slide. Male, we can how we can differentiate male as well as female. The male is elongated one, slippery shape. Female is round one. Okay. Here in male, what it will happen? Actually, in lac insect, mostly hemiptera insects. Hemimetabola is there. In case of male lac insect, that is holometabola. It contains egg, crawler, then pupal stage and adult stage. Four stages is there, especially in male lac insect. In female lac insect, it won't be there. Only egg, crawler, adult will be there. This is the female, especially in lac insect, that male lac insect, it is having holometabolan behavior. Then here, what it will do? After that first molting, it loses the all the appendages. From second molting onwards, here it will that what are the organs it loses, then it will develop again. Legs, antennae, eyes, wings, these are all the appendages. It will develop again in case of male lac insect. Then during the end of the stage, male lac insect, it used to stop the feeding. After that, what it will happen? Here that hind end of the body, here that operculum will be there. Through this operculum, the male insect will emerge. After emergence, next slide, you can see here. This is the female. You see, this is the elongated one, that is a male. From this male, it will emerge. After completing the pupal stage, it will emerge. You can able to see this picture that if above the corner, this is the male, adult male. These are all the adult male. This is a wingless, this is winged one. These are all the adult male. Please mute, others are please. Madam, please. Archanam, please mute for others. Archana ma'am. Hello. Hello.
Girls, please mute yourself.
The female lac insect, I told during initially the crawler stage, we unable to distinguish which one is male as well as female. Here during the first molt, female also, it will lose the all the appendages, antennae, eye and legs, all the appendages it will lose. But in female, like male, it won't develop again. There is a difference between male as well as female. The male insect, these are the appendages, it will develop again, but the female, it won't develop. Here female are the pear shape, globular shape, male are elongated one. Here after the final molt, after the third molt, it is ready for the copulation. Then male insect, it will come mate with female. After that, male, it will die. Whatever we are getting resin, that is from the female lac insect only. After mating, male insect, it will die. We can see these slides. This is that first instar crawler. You see very small one, through naked eye, we can able to see like this only. Under the microscope, we can able to see the entire that antennae, legs, the caudal filament. This is the first instar crawler. Then after that, sexual differentiation will be happening. Depend upon crop, it varies. In case of, for example, in Baisakhi crop, it may take around 120 days to become that sexual differentiation. It will be happening after 120 days. In case of Katki, after 45 days, it will happen. Like that, depend upon crop, it varies. You can see this is female, this is male. Then this is mature lac. Here, how it will fertilize? Actually, one male lac inside, it can fertilize around 40 to 45 female. Then lifespan of adult male only 2 to 3 days. After that, it will die. After mating, male inside, it will die. Whatever we are getting, resin for the female. Then here, resin production depends upon the mating. If without mating, we won't get much resin. Very meager amount of resin only we will be getting. The female secrete more resin after the mating only. Then the fecundity also depends upon the size of the female. The size of the female is very small. We will be getting very less number of young ones. Okay. Then one female, it may produce around 300 to 500 young ones. Then how it is hatching from the matured mother female cell? Actually, what it will happen during the maturation, that mother female lac inside, it will create this space. You can see that right corner picture is there. It will create this space. Due to the creation of space, some yellow spot appearance will be there. Here, that female mother cell, it will lay eggs. In this space, it will lay the eggs. Then after that, immediately from that egg, whatever the crawlers, it will be coming outside. That is the ovoviviparity lac inside. Mostly the emergence will take place depending upon the environment. It varies. If it is a very cool period, it emerges very slowly. If it is very hot, it will emerge very quickly. Maximum emergence takes place in morning time. In the evening time, it will be very slow. This is the whole entire life cycle of lac insect. You can see this is crawler or nymphal stage. From this male-female differentiation is happening. After that, male is emerging, mating with female. After mating, male it will die. Whatever we are getting the resin, that is from female, then mature female. This is the whole lac insect life cycle. Then each and every crop, I already told, some lifespan is differ. In case of Katki season crop, around 16 weeks for completing entire life cycle, it needs 16 weeks. In case of Baisakhi summer crop, it needs 36 weeks for completing entire that crop period, 36 weeks. In Kusmi crop, in Agani crop, it needs around 28 weeks for completing entire crop. In case of summer Jethvi crop, it needs around 24 weeks. Then you can see the lag crop cycle. Actually, for Rangini and Kusmi, the crop cycle mostly varies. Rangini, we can say unequal duration. Kusmi, we can say equal duration. In case of Rangini, actually, rainy season crop, that is Katki, lac insect, mostly it will emerge in the month of June, July. Then we will be inoculating in the month of June, July. Then it will be ready for harvesting in the month of October, November. It will take around 4 months. In case of summer Baisakhi crop, we used to inoculate in the month of October, November. Then it will be ready for harvesting in the month of June, July. Around it will take 8 months. That is summer Rangini crop. In case of Kusmi lac insect, mostly summer and winter both are equal duration. In case of winter crop, we used to inoculate in the month of June, July. Then it will be ready for harvesting in the month of January, February. In case of summer Kusmi crop, we used to inoculate in the month of January, February. It will be ready for harvesting in the month of June, July. This is the crop cycle of lac insect. Then I already told for cultivating, for culturing lac insect, we need specific host plant. We can call it as lac host. These are some of the major lac host plant. You can see the picture here. This is a kusum tree, Salicylura oleosa, then Pallas, Bitia monosperma, then Berg, Jujubus mauritiana, then Semilata, Flaminia semilata. These are some of the major host plant used for cultivating lac insect. Then some of the, actually for cultivating lac insect, we are having some of the different lac culture operation is there. If you want to cultivate lac insect, if you are not having any host tree, here Jharkhand and Chhattisgarh, this area, plenty of host plant is available, like Pallas, Ber, Kusum, plenty of host plant available. In case of Punjab, Haryana, those area, it may not be available. Then we can go for nursery raising. We can initiate with nursery. Nowadays, we are having bushy host plant like Flamingia semilata and Calendra calothuriensis. We can start with nursery. And then these are all the operations. Nursery raising, then after that transplanting, then pruning of host tree, then inoculation or infestation of host tree, removing of use of broodlug, that is punky, that is empty stick. Then after that, crop protection measures, then harvesting. These are all the different operations used for lac cultivation. I will be telling out one by one. First, nursery raising. Actually, if you are not having any host plant, we can start with nursery raising. In case of Flamingia semilata, we can go for two methods of nursery raising. First, the seed bed method. Second one is polybag method. Seed bed method around 9 meter length, 2 meter width, and 10 to 15 centimeter height. We have to prepare the seed bed. Then we can sow the seed during the month of May. Similarly, polybag method, we have to fill with the pot mixture. From that, we have to sow the seeds. After that, if you are putting that seeds in the month of May, then plants, it will be ready for during that month of July. July, mostly the rainy season time. During that time, we can go for transplanting. Before transplanting, we have to prepare the field. In case of Flamingia semilata, paired row system we used to follow. We have to dig like 1 feet, 1 feet, 1 feet. That pit we have to make it. After that, before planting, we have to maintain the space. Between the plant, we have to keep 1 meter distance. Between the row, I told paired row system, between the row, we can keep 50 or 75 centimeter. According to our availability, we can keep. And then between the paired row system, we can give 5 meter for if you want to cultivate any fruit crops like guava, then some citrus, if we can integrate some fruit crops, we have to give the space 5 meter. If you want to cultivate any vegetable crops, we can go for 2.5 or 3 meter. If you are keeping 3 meter, tractor we can, for plowing operation, weeding operation, it is very easy. The 3 meter we can keep. If you are planting 2020 July, then 2021, after 1 year, it will be ready for that lac inoculation. That semilata, within 1 year, it will be ready for lac inoculation. Then, after that, after 6 months, we can go for harvesting lac. That is a very feasible crop. Nowadays, farmers, they are started to do lac cultivation on Flamingia semilata. In case of bear also, we can raise. If you want pit method, like 45 centimeter, we can make a pit. Then here, space between the plant, 4 meter. Between the row also, 4 meter. But in case of bear, we have to wait for around 5 to 6 years. After that only, we can go for inoculation of lac insect. This is the nursery raising. Sometimes in this Jharkhand and Chhattisgarh area, farmers are having plenty of tree. If they are having plenty of tree, there is no need to raise any nursery. They can start with this operation, pruning operation. Actually, pruning. Why we have to go for pruning? For that purpose, actually to ensure availability of tender shoot. Initially, I told in the beginning, like inside it suck the phloem sap, it needs tender suit. Then only it able to suck through the proboscis, it will suck the sap. For that purpose, we have to prune the tree to ensure availability of large number of shoots. If you are pruning, means we will be getting more number of shoots. Then to remove unwanted shoots, to remove some spider net on the host tree, to provide rest of the host tree for maintaining its potential. Actually, continuously we are cultivating lag without pruning, means sometimes the branches may dry. For that, for providing rest, we have to prune the tree. Then to give suitable shape also for cultivation operations are very easy. If you are pruning, if you are not pruning, means sometimes that we could not make some cultivation practices like harvesting, inoculation. It is very difficult. For that purpose, we used to prune the tree. Then when we have to prune, actually depend upon host tree, it varies. In case of palas, bear, that galwang, balia, semilata, kalindra, these are all the host plant. 5 to 6 month prior to inoculation, we can go for pruning. But in case of kusum, the tree is very slow growing tree. For that purpose, we have to prune 1 year or 18 months before inoculation. Then only we can go for lack inoculation. We have to prune around 12 to 18 months before. You can see this picture. Actually, after pruning, some of the new shoots are coming from the, you can see these are all the, some of the new shoots are coming from bear. This is from palas. You can see this is the, some pencil thickness shoot. Okay, here also you can see this is the right stage. If you are getting this stage, we can go for if it is very harder, but if you are inoculating also, sometimes we will be getting very less yield. Like insect, it won't suck the shell from the very hard shoot. It needs tender shoot. Succulent shoot is needed. Now pruning has done. After that, actually lack insect, it won't spread. Automatically it won't spread. We have to introduce or we have to inoculate. For inoculate, what we have to do, this is the continuous life cycle. This is live material. We can see if you are not inoculating, if you are not cutting lag, sometimes it, mostly it it is a crawlers, it is become wasted. For that purpose, what we have to do, we are after harvesting from the twig, we have to cut in the twig around 15 to 20 centimeter length. After that, we have to make a bundle. Then we have to inoculate on the tree. In case of bushy host plant like semilata, it needs around only 20 to 30 grams. For that, small twigs, we can inoculate on semilata. In case of bear, palas, kusum, it needs around 100 gram, minimum 50 to 100 gram. 50 gram it needs for red gram, those bushy host. For bear, kusum, palas, it needs around 100 gram. For thumb rule is there, for 1 meter shoot length, it needs minimum 10, maximum 20 gram of brood lack is necessary. Accordingly, you can calculate. You can see after pruning how many new shoots are is there. Then you can see the length approximately. If you are after pruning around 5 to 6 shoots is there, it means 5 meter during that branch you can inoculate. Automatically it will go and settle. Then another one thing we can use some synthetic nylon net. From synthetic nylon net, or is bamboo case also we can use for inoculation of brood lag. Then you can see the picture here, how they are inoculating. You see, they have inoculated here. After pruning, you can see around 5 to 6 new shoots are there. It means around 6 meter. Then 100 gram lag insect bundle, they are inoculating here. From that, new crawlers it will emerge from here, then automatically it will go and settle on new shoots. Okay. Similarly, in palas also, they are inoculating only here. From here, it will go and settle on these branches. But it won't come here. For that purpose, we used to inoculate here. Okay. Then another one operations I told, removing of used or proved, like it means empty, that empty stick. Why we have to remove, when we have to remove, how we have to remove. First I will be telling why we have to remove. Actually, for lac crop, like other agriculture and vegetable crop also, like lac crop, it is also having some pest problem. Some enemy insect is there. If from previous crop, matured crop, if you are not removing the punki, most of the natural enemies having the life cycle period around minimum 30 to maximum 45 days. If you are not removing the punki, some of the enemy lac crop, it will be affect your new crop. For that purpose, we have to prevent excess of enemy insect to new crop, we have to remove the punki. Then to avoid wastage of lac. Mostly in lac ecosystem, we are inoculating the brood lac. Brood lac, that is seed material. After that, the empty that stick, that is the punki, mostly that punki, we used to scrap the punki. Those that is a resin. That punki, it contains a resin, wax and dye. Those resin only we used to sell to market from and industry people. They will buy, they will process further. For that purpose, to avoid wastage of lac, we have to remove the punki. Then we can sell. Okay. When we have to prune, then I told the lac crawler, it won't emerge single day. It will keep on emerging. Minimum 15 to maximum 21 days, it will be emerging lac crawler. Depend upon crop, depend upon season, it varies. If a crawler emergency stop, we can go for, we can remove the punki. Then thumb rule is there, within 3 weeks, we have to remove the punki. Otherwise, some of the new, that parasitoid predator, it will come, it will affect your new crop. Then how we can remove, using some that dowli, we have to cut the plastic string, we can remove easily. Then after that punki removal, I already told, in lac, we are having two value crop. One is brood lac for seed material, another one is the stick lac. From the stick lac only, it contains resin, wax, dye. Then mostly the stick lac, we used to sell to market. Like, from the stick lac, they used to scrap. Either we can do for manually, or we can go for some. In our institute, we have developed that lac scrapper cum crusher machine. From this machine also, we can go for scrapping. After that, whatever the scrapped material is there, then we can sell to market. At present, 1 kg of that scrapped lac, minimum 400 to 450 rupees we are selling through market. Then, like other crops, lac also having some of the pest problem. Then how we can manage this pest problem, we can see here. Before going this, I will just briefing you in lac ecosystem, what all the trophic level is there. Okay, here in lac ecosystem, 4 trophic level is there. We can see the first trophic level. These are the host plant, whatever may be. Either kusum, palas, or bear. This is the first trophic level, that host plant. In second trophic level, we are inoculating lac. Then after that, whatever pest is coming, it will be come under the second trophic level. You can see this lac insect is there. Okay, then pest of host plant is there. These are all the, it will be come under the second trophic level. In third trophic level, pest of lac insect and some of the beneficial insect also is there in lac ecosystem. This, it will come under the third trophic level. Some of the pest like predator and parasitoid, these are the pest, it will come under the trophic level, third trophic level. In fourth trophic level, some beneficial insect, it will come. You can see lac host plant. After that, we used to inoculate lac insect. Then from lac insect, some of the pest like parasitoid predator, it will come. Then to affect, to kill those parasitoid and predator larvae, some of the hyper parasitoid will come. These are the different trophic level in the LAC ecosystem. Then actually, for getting higher production and productivity, we need very healthy suits without damage the plant. We need some very good host plant. The productivity depends upon the availability of the healthy suits. Then LAC host also having some of the pest problem, like sucking pest. Then some borer defoliator also is there. Around 19 major and 61 sporadic and minor pests we have reported from the LAC host plant. Then these are some of the pest of LAC insect. Actually, for LAC cultivation, we have to consider both LAC host as well as LAC insect. If you want to manage pest, we have to manage the pest both LAC host as well as LAC insect. LAC insect having around 19 predator, we have recorded. Then the predator are more serious. Around 30 to 35% damage due to the predator. These are the three major predator. You can see the picture here. You see the Euglena amabilis. We can call it as white moth. That larvae, mostly the larvae, this destructive stage. It will be feed on through LAC incrustation. You can see here that black moth larvae, that Pseudohippotopa pulveria. Then third one is Chrysoprolla. That species. These are the three major LAC insect predator. Then some of the parasitoid also, it will be affecting LAC insect. Around 26 parasitoid we have reported. Out of 26, these five are regular occurrence, like Aprocitus purpureus, Tachardificus tachardii, or Tintoricus clavicarius, Euplumus tachardii, and Citrus doughtii. These are the five parasitoid we are getting regularly. Among the five, this Aprocitus purpureus and Tachardificus tachardii. These two are very major problematic one. You can see here the symptoms of parasitic infestation. Some small hole is there. Actually, here that lag crop cycle is a minimum 4 months, a maximum 8 months. And Kusmi crop around 6 months. But in case of parasitoid, the life cycle is around 30 to 35 days, maximum 40 days only. Actually, for 1 lakh crop, that parasitoid, it may complete around 4 generations. That's why if initially the parasitoid infested with lakh insect means, after 30 to 35 days, automatically that adult, it will emerge from the lakh incrustation. Then after emergence, automatically lakh insect will die. That is the major problem one. Then these are only some of the beneficial insects. Actually, here what it will happen, you can see the picture, Brachan greeny and Apoidalis. These are only some beneficial insect. This beneficial insect, it will kill the larvae of predator. Like Apoidalis, it will kill, it will devour larvae of Pseudohippotopa pulveria. Like Brachan greeny, it will eat or it will devour the larvae of Euglena amabilis. These are the hyperparasitoid, beneficial for LAC insect, harmful for pest of LAC insect. Then how we can collect actually in LAC ecosystem, like other agriculture crop, mostly what we used to do as a zoologist or entomologist, we used to go to field, we used to count the number. How many number of aphid is there? How many number of scale insect? How many number of larvae is there? But LAC insect is very difficult. Parasites are very small size. This photograph we have taken through microscope only. Through naked eye, we are unable to see. For that purpose, our institute, we have developed that parasitoid emergence cage we have developed. For this, what we used to do, we used to cut the sample. Then we used to put the sample inside the cage. Some glass tubes are there. You can see here, borosil glass tubes are there. Most of the insects are phototrophic in nature. Then whatever predator and parasitoid is there, due to phototrophic nature, it will come towards light. Then from these tubes, we can collect parasitoid predator. After that, we can separate it out, like Aprocitus, how many number of Aprocitus is there, how many number of Tachardifagus, how many number of predator is there, we can separate it out. These are all these, how we can collect LAC associated fauna from that lab crop. How we can go for pest management? For I already told cultivation practices, that crop protection measures, one of the major one. The pest management, like other crop, we can follow IPM practices here also. Before going chemical insecticide, we can go for some preventive measure, cultural control, then mechanical control, biological control, then chemical control. Different heading I will be dealing. In preventive measures, first of all, we have to choose healthy and mature. We have to choose. If we are getting healthy brood lack, means automatically that pest population will be very minimum. Then after that, I told earlier also, we have to remove punki, that empty stick, within 3 weeks after inoculation. Then after that removal of punki, we have to scrap. After removal of punki, if you are keeping that punki nearby your field, then from that punki also, that parasitoid predator, it will emerge. It will affect your new crop. For that purpose, we have to scrap or we have to fumigate to kill the parasitoid and predator larvae or some grubs. Some general rule is there. We should not cultivate kusmi and rangini on same place. Why we are telling? For example, rangini summer crop, it is having 8 months crop. Rangini summer crop, we used to inoculate in the month of October, November. And then it will be ready for harvesting June, July. But in case of kusmi summer crop, we used to inoculate in the month of January, February. Then it will be ready for harvesting in the month of June, July. That's why if you are cultivating both rangini and kusmi on same place, sometimes some parasitoid and predator population from Baisakhi crop, it will be affecting your that kusmi summer crop. For that purpose, there is a general rule, we should not cultivate kusmi rangini on same place. Then some of the cultural control, for that purpose, we can go for some yearly inoculation. Some 10 to 50 days yearly, we can go for inoculation of lac inside. Then if you are inoculating very yearly with the higher brood rate, we can avoid that pest population. Then like trap crop, we can use that if you are having one big field in that border area, we can inoculate heavy higher brood rate. And after sometimes we can harvest lac from the border area. Then mostly if you are inoculating heavy lac insect, most of the pest it will attract towards the heavy population of lac insect. For that purpose, like trap crop, we can use some intercropping. We can go in lac ecosystem, we can cultivate in between lac crop, we can cultivate some cotton and bendi like intercrop. Here what it will happen, in cotton and bendi also having some of the pest problem, like pink spotted bollworm is there in case of cotton and okra. That for devour or for killing pink and spotted bollworm, Bracon greeny used to come. That Bracon greeny, it will beneficial for lac insect. For that purpose, we used to recommend intercrop between the lac crop. Then some of the mechanical control, this is a very good method. Before inoculation, we can use some 60 mesh synthetic net. If you are using synthetic net, the size is very small, 60 mesh. Through the 60 mesh, lac crawler, it will emerge. But that parasitoid predator are very bigger size. It unable to emerge, it unable to come outside from 60 mesh synthetic net. For that purpose, we used to inoculate lac with synthetic net. But this synthetic net practices, mostly we should not follow in case of rainy season crop. Mostly we used to recommend in summer crop. Then microbial control, we can go for spray like Bacillus thuringiensis against the larvae of Euglena and Pseudoepiphyta pulveria. In biological control, in naturally available ant species like Camponotus, Solanopsis, these are all the naturally available. These ants, mostly it will attack the larvae and pupae of Euglena and Pseudoepiphyta pulveria. Then we can release some of the egg parasitoid like Trichogramma chylonis, Trichogramma brasiliensis, to kill the eggs of Euglena mobilis. Then these are all the chemical control, like other crop. In other crop, we can tell. We can go for a systemic insecticide. We can go for contact insecticide. But lac crop, we should not recommend blindly. Here, lac insect also insect. If you blindly we are spraying, means sometimes we will it will kill the our lac insect also. That's why before go for any spray, whatever we are recommending from our institute, then those insecticide you can go for spray. So otherwise, sometimes farmers use some blindly, then we may lose our lac crop. Our institute, what we will do before recommending any insecticide, we will be test against lac insect whether this insecticide is safe for lac insect or not. After that only we will check whether it is effective against predator pest or not. This is the thing. First we have to do safety study. After that we can go for management of predator and parasite. These are the some of the recommended insecticide: fipronil, indoxacarb, spinosad, and ethofenprax. You can see the doses I can give later on. Then actually in lac insect, mostly it excrete honeydew. Because of honeydew excretion, then sooty mold problem will come. That's sooty mold, that is a fungi. Sooty mold problem will come. To manage the sooty mold, we have to spray either garamondycin or chlorothalonil or hexaconazole as per recommended dosage. Actually, sooty mold problem is very major in case of rainy season crop and agony crop. Then, like other seed treatment, we are also having that brood treatment of brood lac with insecticide. Here, before inoculation, we can dip the brood lac with insecticide solution. For that, around that recommended dosage like fipronil, 1.5 ml. In 1 liter of water, we can take. You can take one big bucket or one dub. And then for that, after bundling, we have to keep the bundles around 10 to 15 minutes inside the solution. The insecticide solution. After that, we have to remove and we can keep it in shadow. Then whatever matured parasite and predator population is there, it will kill. Then pest management crop wise, actually here I told four crop is there. The crop wise it varies. Pest management insecticide no problem, but that depend upon time of spray it varies. In case of rangini summer crop, mostly it needs we used to recommend three spray. One is 30 days after inoculation, second spray is after 60 to 65 days after inoculation. Then third spray, 130 to 135 days after inoculation. These are the common recommended practices. Sometimes if you want additional spray, then as per your need, you can go. Here one general thing you have to see. I told that the male emergence will be taking place a particular day or a particular time. You can see here in case of Baisakhi summer crop, that male emergence will take place around 105 to 125 days. During in between this time, we should not spray. Why? Actually, during male emergence, if you are spraying, means male insect it will die. If male insect we are it is dying, means automatically it will unable to mate with female. Then automatically your productivity will be very less. For that purpose only, we should not spray during the male emergence period. In case of rangini, two spray is recommended. We should not spray during male emergence period. You see, 42 to 58 days. During this period, male will emerge. During that time, we should not spray. In case of Kusmi winter crop, we are recommending three spray. Then if you want any number more spray, according to your crop, we can go. But we are recommending three spray. Here also you see the male emergence will be taking place between 45 to 58 days. During this period, we should not spray. During spraying, no need to go for separate spray for insecticide and fungicide. We can mix together insecticide and fungicide. Then we can go for single spray, both insecticide and fungicide. In case of jethvi crop, we are recommending three spray. During male emergence, like 65 to 88 days, we should not spray. This is the final operation, harvesting. I told pruning, after that pruning, inoculation, then after inoculation, punki removal, then after punki removal, pest management, then now your crop is ready, and now we can go for harvest. Then for harvesting also, we have to see these things. What is yellow spot? What to observe? Then sometimes some confusion there with perspiration. Then we have to select advanced stage, then when to harvest. These are all the different points we have to see. Like insect, it is the live material. Actually, if not matured, but sometimes farmers, before maturation, they used, if you are harvested means, then crawler it won't emerge. For that purpose, we have to see these are all the things. Then you see what is yellow spot. Okay, yellow spot I told earlier, here after maturation, that mother female lac insect you used to create the space. In that space, it is female insect, it will lay the eggs. From that eggs, young one will come. Then, but it will be there inside. Due to the yellow spot appearance, we can able to see what is the stage. You see this picture. You see here, this is stage zero. Here, there is no yellow spot here. If you are harvesting during this stage, we won't get any crawler. Okay. In stage one also, you can see very minor yellow spot is there. During the stage one, only that initiation of head is taking place. Okay. In stage two, you can see the yellow spot here. Some lines are prominent. During this stage, the heads are very prominent. You can see here, this is stage three. Yellow spots also, V-shaped yellow spot is there. You can see here, head, thorax, abdomen. All up under that stage, you can see the head, thorax, abdomen very prominently. During the stage four, we can able to see the eye. Before that, we are able to see the eye also. You can see yellow spot here. Okay. In stage 5, half of the portion become yellow color. If you are breaking, these are all the outside the stage. These are the photograph I have taken inside the microscope. Okay. If you are breaking the cells, we can able to see the different stages. If you are breaking the stage 5, we can able to see the crawler. Crawler will be there inside. Okay. The time of harvesting, accordingly, we have to see. In case of agony, during the stage 5, agony, there is a winter season crop, the lac crawler, it will be emerging very slowly. If during the stage 5 only, we have to go for harvesting. If you are harvesting either stage 2 or stage 1, we may get very minimum number of crawler. Okay. Like in case of summer crop, both rangini and kusmi, we have to go for stage 4 or stage 3. We can go for that. We can go for harvesting the stage 3 or 4 during kusmi summer and rangini summer. In case of rainy season crop, we can harvest in the stage 4. Okay. But farmers unable to see, for that purpose, we used to say, in case of winter crop, some of the crawler emergence, if you're able to notice in the field, you can go for harvest. In case of summer crop, we can go for 3 to 4 days before crawler emergence. Okay. In farmers, we used to say this thing. Then you can see this graph. In 1958, they have grown mostly all over the India. You can see in Tamil Nadu, Kerala, and then Karnataka, all over the India, lac were cultivating during 1958. And 2001, we have survey. After survey, we made this diagram. You can see here, only then Jharkhand, Chhattisgarh, and some of the part of that north is Assam area. And then here in Maharashtra, only few pockets they are cultivating lac. These are all the 10 number of lac species endangered. Earlier it was there. And during 2001, we couldn't get this population, like Kerria Champorelli. These are the 10 lac insect already endangered. Based on what in our institute, for this purpose, our institute, we have started some network project. Now, under the network project, we are having all over India 8 different center, three voluntary center, from which we have started survey from 2014 onwards. Now all over the India we are getting lakh. The natural population is available. From this now taxonomically and molecularly we can able to tell whether this endangered species we are getting again or not. Okay, you can see these are all the place now the lakhs are growing in Jharkhand, Gujarat, Telangana, Andhra Pradesh, Assam. Then what are the advantage, the merits of lakh production? It is very much suited for rainfed area. Then very good opportunity for employment generation for youngsters. Then additional opportunity in employment factory.
Oh, usko sorry, bhul jata hu yaar.
Hello. Actually, it is we can get employment opportunity through the lakh production as well as their processing. Then very easy marketability in Jharkhand, Chhattisgarh area, in that hot nearby market also they used to buy. Like vegetable we are selling, like they used to buy that scrap lakh market itself. Then very good, we can protect from deforestation. Actually, in for lakh, for cultivating lakh, just we are telling only pruning. If you regularly we are getting income from the one tree, mostly the farmers, they won't cut the tree. Okay, then we can use for degraded land like bare palas. It will grow in a degraded land also. Then for conservation point also, if you are cultivating lakh insect throughout the year, then we can conserve. Otherwise, sometimes after 10 or 20 years, here we can lose our lakh insect population. Okay, then very minimum manpower is required. Like some agriculture crop for vegetable cultivation, sometimes weekly thrice or daily we have to go. But in lakh ecosystem, monthly once we can go, we can get very good production. For inoculation, we have to go. After that, we have to go for punki removal. Then sprays. If you go for three spray, then three spray. In between, you can go only every month, monthly one visit. If you are going, means we will be getting very good lakh. Minimum manpower is required. Then we can integrate with some agriculture and horticulture crop. You can see these are the lakh integrated farming system developed by our institute. We can integrate some of the fruit crops in between the lakh crop. You can see semolata. Amla is there, then guava is there, some citrus also is there. Then we have developed some other model. We can integrate some of the vegetable crops, maize. You can see here tomato in between the semolata. Then these are the field level demonstration. Farmers, they have adopted semolata with lakh crop. You can see they have planted calindra, semolata, and some of the vegetable crop. Can see the picture. These are the lakh integrated agroforestry model in Ranchi. They have developed semolata with vegetable crop. Some they are growing some calindra also. What are the merits of lakh dressing? Lakh dressing dissolves very easily. It has excellent adhesion nature. And then electrical property is there in lakh dressing. Then it remarkable adhesion to the mica. It will sticky nature. It will very sticky to mica. Then powerful bonding material with low thermal conductivity and thermoelasticity also is there. Then resistance to variety of solvents, particularly hydrocarbon. Then that is a very waterless and tasteless. These are all some of the merits of lakh resin. Then these are all the industries based on lakh. You can see here earlier during 1960s. For making gramophone, lakh one of the main product. And then today it replaces some vinyl. Today nowadays that we are not at all using the CD also. Now the pen drive has come. Then these are some varnishes and polishes industry, then pharmaceutical industry, confectionery industry, then adhesive industry, painting inks, electrical and leather and wood finishing, and fruit and vegetable coating. These are all the things you can see one by one. Like in food industry, for coating of fruits, candies, chocolate, we are using that lac resin. For coating of coffee beans also. And then for marking ink for food, we are using that lac resin. For fortification of cereals with micronutrient, we are using that lac resin. In varnishes and paint industry, for painting furnitures, some musical instrument, actually for violin, especially in Germany, they are importing lac resin for coating of lac resin for violin only. Actually, they used to say if you are coating with lac resin, that sound quality is very good. For that purpose, they used to import for finishing repair terracotta, we can use lac resin. Then for cosmetic and jewelry industry, for manufacturing of bangles, earrings, some for manufacturing of perfumes, some hairspray, eyeshadow for eyeliner, some lipstick, our institute, we have developed nail polish also from our ANRG we have developed. Then in lac bangles in Rajasthan area for marriage purpose, still they are following. Actually, this compulsory by wearing lac bangles for the brides, still they are using. You can see some of the product that coated with lac resin. You can see bangles, some that pen stand is there. You can see bangles, pen stand, mobile stand. These are all the. Then in adhesive industry also, lac resin is used for gasket cement compound. For cutting diamond crystal cutting, they used to use that resin. For paper adhesive tag and sealing wax also, they are using. In pharmaceutical industry, for putting off tablets, in Kerala, Ayurvedic medicine, Unani medicine, still they are using. And our network project, our project center, they have recorded what are the Ayurvedic they are using. Then it has electrical property. For this, you can see it has containing very good electrical property. For that, for coating of isolator, sparking plug, they are using lac resin. Then in lac dye, what are the application for coloring of cloth, for coloring of tablet, for coloring of chocolate coating, we can use lac dye. Then application of lac wax for making shoe polish and floor polishes, for coating of fruit also, we can use lac wax. Due to the stiffiness, if you are using for making stiffening of cat, we can use lac resin. For tightening also, for making firecracker, we are using most of the people they are using lac resin. Particularly, it contains some bioactive chemical compound, aluric acid. For isolating aluric acid only, most of the country they are exporting lac from India. After that, they are making aluric acid. Then again, they are importing to India or some other country. It contains so many uses. Aluric acid we can use in pharmaceutical industry. We can use bioactive compound preparation industry. Some hormone trap industry also we can use. These are all the uses. Then finally, I will tell about forward and backward linkage in marketing of lac. For marketing of lac, you can see. Here grower producer is there. From that lac grower, they used to sell nearby paikar, the trader. From the trader, wholesaler, they used to purchase. Sometimes lac grower, that paikar directly, they will go to lac Arkatia. And then wholesaler also, they will sell the scrap lac to lac Arkatia. From wholesaler, it goes to lac processor. From that lac processor, they will export the whatever shellac, shellac, those things they will export. And then another one channel is there, some government organization like LAMPS, PACS, VAMS, these are the some of the organizations. They will buy with minimum support price, like other wheat and rice. Lac also having minimum support price. With minimum support price, they will buy and then they will directly, they will export. then they can sell to some domestic consumption also. These are the marketing channel. And then how that processing they used to take place, both manually and mechanically. We can go for lac processing. Then manual unit available, many number, initially I told, in West Bengal, many number is there. In some of the traditionally, locally, they are using lac, like in Bihar, Rajasthan, Jaipur, Uttar Pradesh, Varanasi, these are all the places. They are still for making bangles, some other purpose, they are using lac. Around 150 process unit is there for preparing sheet lac, shell lac, bleach lac, lac dye, butter lac, pyruvic acid. These are all the some of the byproduct of lac. You can see this map. You see that large scale processing unit available in only in West Bengal. Very very big units are available in West Bengal. Some of the area domestic consumption is there in West Bengal, Balrampur, then Bihar, then UP, Varanasi, then Rajasthan, Jaipur, in Hyderabad also domestic consumption. They are making some bangles. They are using some other purposes. Then small scale process unit. It is available in Chhattisgarh, Jharkhand, some of the in Chhattisgarh, Maharashtra also. Then the export center, it will export through Delhi, Mumbai and Calcutta. These are the exporting area. Then what are the organizations are involving for lac production or giving training to farmers? Foremost one, our institute, ICR, Indian Institute of Natural Resins and Gums. It started in 1924, in British period, about to complete 100 years. Still we are giving training to farmers, giving training to master trainer, some entrepreneurship also we are developing. Then others like Trifed, Trifel Cooperative Marketing Development Federation, then JASCOLAM, Jharkhand State Cooperative Lac Marketing Procurement Federation. In Chhattisgarh also, through the state government, they are giving training. In Madhya Pradesh also having Madhya Pradesh State Minor Farmer Produce and Cooperation Federation. In Andhra Pradesh, Grigen Cooperative Corporation and Kowal Foundation. In Visakhapatnam also, they are having, these are some NGOs. They are giving training to farmers. Thank you. These are all the things I told about lac insect life cycle, crop cycle, then how to cultivate, how we can go for lac cultivation operations, then what are the uses, then marketing, how we can go for marketing. These are all the things. Then if you have any doubt, you can ask. After that, I have kept some of the display here. I will go a few hours, around 10 to 15 minutes or half an hour for demonstration. I will show live population, live lac insect, some of the displays there. If you have any doubt, you can ask first. Later on, I will show. Thank you very much, ma'am, for giving opportunity to give about a brief view, entire things, lac culture, especially to Archana, ma'am. Archana, ma'am, she did some under DBT project. She worked here. She only asked me. Then after that, that Sadhana madam, she accepted her request. Thank you very much, both of you. And thank you to entire student for listening very nicely. If you have any doubt, you can ask. Please, thank you.
Thank you so much, sir, for your inputs. We are very grateful that you accepted our invitation. So, students, if you have any queries, you can ask.
Yes, students. Girls, ask if you have any doubts.
Mobile.
Workshop to math.
Sir, I think you can continue with demonstration.
No, any doubt is there, please, you can ask. Don't hesitate. Okay.
Yes.
This is very new to you, Lakh Insight. Before joining me also, it is very new. Sometimes some doubt, definitely it will come. Don't hesitate. You can ask any question. Please, students.
You can also write in the chat box.
You can do the chat box. I will see.
You can also write questions in the chat box if you are hesitating in asking, sir.
Girls, if you have any doubts, you can write in chat box. Sir, I think you can continue with demonstration.
There's one question.
I have received one question. What is sooty mold and management? Okay. Actually, sooty mold, that is the fungus. Lakh Insight mostly excrete honeydew. Because of excretion of honeydew, some fungal problem. Some sooty mold symptom. Actually, some black appearance will be there. That is the fungus. Because of excretion of honeydew, mostly it will come. For that purpose, we have to go for spray. Okay. For fungicide, like already we are recommending garam decim, around 1 ml, 1 gram per liter of water. Then otherwise chlorothalonil, 1 gram per liter of water. If you are, otherwise we can go for hexaconazole, 1 ml per liter of water. If you are spraying this, we can able to manage the sooty mold. Okay.
Yes, sir. Thank you, sir.
Welcome.
So there is another question regarding yellow spot.
Yellow spot. Madam, actually in Lakh Insight, that yellow spot is very much important. Actually, before yellow spot or before maturation, if you are harvesting Lakh Insight, sometimes we may not get young ones. Okay. For that purpose, maturity, that maturation of female insight is very much important. How we can see the maturity? Due to yellow spot, we can able to see the maturation. Okay. If it is yellow spot is very small, if you are harvesting those stage, sometimes we may get very, if your lakh crop is good, we could get around 400 to 500 crawlers. If you are cutting very early, we may get only 100. For that purpose only, the yellow spot is very much important. During that stage 5, if yellow spot become prominent, during that time we are harvesting, means automatically the young ones will be very more. The productivity will be very more. That's why yellow spot is very much important.
Yes, Muskan, you want to ask something?
Then you're able to see, this is the sooty mold. You see here. That black color is there. Who asked the
yes,
Gauruji? Please see. These are the sooty mold.
Okay.
Actually, what it will happen, in Lakh Insect, it contains 3 spores. One is 2 tracheal pore, one is anal pore. That sooty mold, it will cover the, it will close the that pore. Because of closing pore, Lakh Insight unable to respirate. If you are unable to respirate, means automatically Lakh Insight it will die. There is a sooty mold. Okay.
Can yes,
you
sir.
Are you able to see?
Yes, sir.
This thing. Okay. Thank you. If there is no question, just I will show live population. Some demo also is there. I will show you. Okay. Can you able to see the display board?
Yes, sir. Yeah.
Okay. Ek danda de do na. Wo le lo pehle. I have explained everything you see here. Okay. These are the different stages of lacking sex. First, the crawler, then female. I will show separately. These are all the lac insect and its byproduct. This is that sticky leg. This is the crimson color. This is yellow color. And these are the crab leg, seed leg, button leg. From this lac dye, bleached leg, lutic acid, crude form lutic acid. Lac wax also is there. These are all the display board. Then I will show you the crawler. Crawler like you, very like you. It's tool record. Actually, lac inside very small, small size. Okay, here I. Actually, we used to inoculate lac inside with the synthetic net. I already explained earlier. Here, the synthetic net, only the crawler. Here, very small, small size crawler. I can able to see, but I don't know whether you are able to see or not. This is very small, small crawler you see here. Then it has settled also. You see your lens there, don't these are all the lac inside crawler. It has settled here. I will try to show you through lens. The guy there, I am.
No, it's nahi, not.
Okay, it is very small size, ma'am. I can't do anything. I will give the slides. Then you can show later on also. Okay. This is the crawler stage. Next. X tool. Or you can see here. This is the sexual differentiation stage. Sexual dimorphism. Here I can able to see, but for you it's very difficult. These are also very small. That female are round or globular shape, and male are elongated one. You can see these are all the females. Then some of the that you can hear caudal filament is there. The elongated one are male. Male, it has emerged. Here the mating is going on. Here the male insect is there. Here mating is going on. I can able to see, but for you, can you able to see?
Sir, it that's is out of the camera focus. This part.
Camera focus. Okay. Because some mating is going on.
Yes, now it's visible.
Now it's visible, ma'am.
Yeah.
These are all the that elongated one, that is male. Then round one, that is female. Depend upon crab, it varies. You see here some mating is going on.
Sir, can you magnify my using lens?
Now I will see.
Actually, it gets reflected, so
it's not very clear.
Actually, lac insect itself very small, ma'am. Very small insect, it is giving food to farmers as well as us also for 100 years. You see, very minute insect, it is giving. Everything to farmers as well as whatever scientist is there. For us also, very, very minute insect. Then female cow. I think you can able to see this one.
Yeah.
Yes.
This is visible.
So, na? These are all the wax. Whatever I have removed, these are all the wax. Okay, this is wax. Then, okay, crimson, you know? Oh. This is crimson color lac inside. I will show you after crushing. You can see my finger.
Yes,
yes.
This is crimson color lac inside. Okay, now not fully matured. Actually, kusmi, you know? It will mature in the month of January end or February, okay? Not now. It will take another 1 month to mature, 1 month, 1.5 month to mature, okay? Next, yellow one, like you. Can you able to see yellow color like in segment?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Yellow color. Just I will show you. You can see this head.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Yes, it's clear.
Yellow color. Yellow color is there, na?
Yes.
This is yellow color lac insect. Actually, lac dye nothing but that is a hemolymph. Hemolymph of lac insect. That is a lac dye. Okay, from there we are used to while washing lac through water. Lac dye, it will be removed through water. Then for purification of water, we will be getting lac dye. Okay. Somebody asked yellow spot, na, ma'am. You can see here yellow spot. You see, these are all the yellow spot. Here, everywhere is there. Can you able to see yellow spot?
Yes, sir.
Huh? Yellow spot is there. Can you able to see?
Yes, it's visible, sir.
This is indication of maturation. Okay. Earlier, whatever I have shown, if I'm harvesting those stage, we could not get a crawler. If you are harvesting this stage only, we will be getting crawler. That is the thing. Okay, if I am harvesting whatever shown earlier, that looking matured one, but I am harvesting that stage, I may not get crawler. That's why yellow spot is very much important. Okay. These are the different stages of lac insect. Our pest is the cow. Okay, host problem. I told earlier also lac insect for cultivating lac insect, lac host plant is very much important. Depend upon that healthy suit, we will be getting higher production. For lac insect also, some of the pest it will come. You can see these are all the some of the pest of lac insect. Like snout weevil is there, chaffer beetle, then some blue butterfly, backworm, grasshopper, some termite. These are all the some of the pest of lac host plant. Take care. Then like other crop, I told lac insect also having pest problem. You see here, these are the predators. Eubloma, Pseudohepatopa, then Chrysoprola carnea. These are the predator. Then below one, these are the parasitoids. Aprocitus purpureus, Tachardia saccadi, then P. clavicanis. These are all the parasitoids. Then here hyperparasitoid. This is beneficial for lac insect, harmful for the predator and parasitoid. This is different trophic level. First trophic host plant will be there. Second trophic lac insect. Then third trophic predator and parasitoid will come. Then fourth trophic, then hyperparasitoid will come. Okay. These are all the some of the pest and hyperparasitic kind of lac insect. Okay. Then तो एक एक दिखाओ, ये दे दो इनाकुले, ये प्रूनिंग वाला दे दो, प्रूनिंग वाला, प्रूनिंग प्रूनिंग मैडम. आई टोल्ड फॉर कल्टीवेशन ऑफ ब्लैक इनसेट, इफ यू आर नॉट हैविंग एनी होस्ट प्लांट, वी कैन गो फॉर नर्सरी रेसिंग इन केस for nursery. After that we can go for transplanting. But if you are already having host plant like palas, bear, kusum, if you are having host plant, we have to prune. For pruning we have to use like that dhauli is there, then sikesar is there, some tree pruner is there, you see tree pruner. Using this only we have to prune. Why we have to use this tree pruner, if we are simply we are cutting means sometimes some breakage will be there. To avoid the breakage of shoot, if you have some breakage, if you, there means sometimes the new shoots it won't come, that branch it will die. For the prune, just we have to prune the tree using the tree pruner. Okay. Oh, to be issue nahi. This is the tree pruner. Using tree pruner, we have to prune the branch. Okay. After pruning, the new shoots it will come. Then inoculation all of them. After pruning, we will be getting very lengthy shoot. Okay, more than 1 meter or 1.5 meter. But we cannot inoculate. Actually, in lack inside, it won't go automatically. We have to infest. We have to inoculate. For that, we have to cut into small twig, like 10 to 20 centimeter to small twig. After that, we have to make bundle. You see the bundle? We have made it bundle. Okay. Fear like around 100 gram. The bundle it will be around 100 gram. I told initially for 1 meter shoot length, minimum 10 to maximum 20 gram brood lac is needed. For after pruning, one branch we may get that minimum 5, maximum 6 side branches. For that purpose, one bundle is enough for one branch. Okay, 100 gram. You see, I told that synthetic net. You see the synthetic net. If you after make it small pieces, we have to put inside the synthetic net. From that net, very small size here, 60 mm size crawler it will emerge. Okay, but what are the parasitoid predator is there unable to emerge. For that purpose, we used to use the synthetic net to avoid enemy population from lichens. Okay, this is the inoculation. Then after inoculation, I told. Now, you can think this is a brood lac. We have inoculated on the tree. After 21 days, after 3 weeks, we have to remove it again. Okay. We have to remove it again. Scrap lac hai. We have to remove it again. Then using the dowli, we have to scrap. You see, I am scrapping. Okay. I am scrapping here. Okay, whatever we are getting, that is a real lac resin. Okay, lac resin, it contains resin, wax and dye. Okay, due to the some process, we will be separated out dye and resin and wax also. Okay, these are all the, like this, we can go for some scrapping. Then manually we can do, we have developed one instrument, lac scrapper gum grader. Using that machine also, we can go some scrapping, you see. This scrap one, okay. These are all the we have scrapped from the twig, okay. The farmers they used to sell to market this. This is a scrapped one. I have larva also is there. You see, this is larvae of Eublema. Grigia. You see my hand, one larva is there. Can you able to see larva?
Yes.
White color larva. able to see, ma'am? White color larva is there?
Actually, on a paper, we are not able to make out. But on hand, okay. It was visible. Yeah. Yes.
Can you able to see?
It's visible.
ये देखिए इसमें व्हाइट कलर आल्सो लार्वा इज देयर एंड ब्लैक कलर लार्वा आल्सो इज देयर एंड व्हाइट कलर वन इज सूडो हेपाटा यूब्लम अमाबिलिस देयर ब्लैक कलर वन इज सूडो हेपाटा फलवेरिया आई टोल्ड इन दैट पेस्ट मैनेजमेंट प्रैक्टिसेस वी हैव टू रिमूव द पंकी व्हाई वी हैव टू रिमूव द पंकी एक्चुअली बिकॉज़ ऑफ दिस इफ यू आर नॉट रिमूविंग द पंकी from this larva it becomes pupa then from that adult it will emerge then it will affect your new crop okay for that purpose only we have to remove the punki then we have to scrap it out after scraping then it won't get any food material that will die automatically it will die okay this is very important operation if the farmer is unable to do means automatically then the succeeding crop definitely the farmer will lose the crop okay this is the thing these are all the larvae pupa inoculation pruning this is it dikhao pehle ye wo dikhao pupa hai like this is pupa of Eubloma from this adult it will come then it will affect your new crop this pupa for managing this pest problem we have to already I told only recommended insecticide only we have to go sometimes farmer what they used to do like rice or vegetable crop they used to spray any insecticide sometimes those insecticide they will spray then immediately after spraying they will come here sir I sprayed the crop but lac is not there lac mar gaya pura hi mar gaya इस तरफ का वो किसान लोग बोलता है और उसी के लिए ओनली व्हाट एवर वी हैव रेकमेंडेड डोज यू कैन सी हियर एथोफेनप्राक्स दिस इज एथोफेनप्राक्स देन इंडॉक्साकार्प देन फिप्रोनिल दिस आर द रेकमेंडेड इंसेक्टिसाइड वी कैन गो फॉर स्प्रेइंग देन आई टोल्ड दैट फॉर शूटी मोल्ड वी हैव टू गो दैट वेबिस्टीन दैट कार्बोनेसिन और क्लोरोथलोनिल देन कवास some hexagonosol is there we can go for spraying using this fungicide we can mix together both insecticide and fungicide then we can go for spray no need to go separate spray okay we can mix together compatibility is there we used to do compatibility study also okay then which sprayer we have to use dikhao I think in tree crops mostly the gattur sprayer in mango some orchard crop mostly farmers they will spray for that spraying two person is needed for giving pressure using that piston one person is there for spraying one person is needed okay using gattur sprayer we have to spray for tree crops especially lac crop mostly is there in 2 weeks for that purpose only gattur spray is very much needed okay I think every student might be seen gattur sprayer in mango orchard or guava or some orchard they used to use their gattur sprayer for spraying using this we have to spray so we have to make the solution first after that we one person is needed for giving that pressure another person is needed for this spraying if you want I have some video then I can share also video you can able to see how they are seeing these are all the thing entire operations ma'am these are all the things is needed just I can share one video also I have that one minute madam can you able to see
yes it's visible sir
how they are bundling you can see here You see how they are bundling?
So you can make it full screen. Yes.
The next. Can you able to see enough question, ma'am?
Yes, it's visible, sir.
You see here how they are inoculating. Only that 100 gram bundle is there. They are inoculating here. Then automatically around 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 suits is there. And then from this, automatically it will go and it will settle. Like I said, it will settle. Okay. This is the method of inoculation. You see, he has inoculated here. He is inoculating again here, another one bundle. If he is inoculating only 200 gram, okay, from which we will be getting minimum 1 kg, maximum 1.5 kg. 4 to 5 times we will be harvesting, okay? This is inoculation. Then after that, punki removal. Just we have to remove the whatever empty stick is there. We have to either cut, we have to remove. Okay? This is the punki removal. Then after that, scraping. You see, manually they are scraping. This is scraping. They are doing manually. These are the scrapped luck. Industry people, they will buy the scrap luck. Okay. 1 kg of scrap luck right now around 400 to 450 rupees per kg. Then after that, you can see here also machine. How lakh scrapper gum crusher, you see, our institute we have developed. These are the lakh scrapper gum crusher. Then after that, you see, ma'am, I told 2 persons is needed. One person, he is giving pressure. Okay. Another one person, he will spray like this. I think this, ma'am. These are all the thing, ma'am. I have shown everything. The videos I had, I have shown. These are all the thing. This is a basic thing about lac insect, life cycle, and how we can culture the lac insect. Okay. If you have any doubt, again, you can ask now also. Or else you can send email. I have given my email also. This is my email ID. mohan.inrg@gmail.com. Then my mobile number is 9931830749. If somebody wants to do some survey or somebody wants to do, sir, I want to do lac here also in Punjab area for fruit coating. For kino fruit coating, nowadays they are using some synthetic one. For lac resin, we can recommend. Now in Punjab PAU, we are having one center, Punjab Agricultural University, one of the center of our INRG. They have started. They are doing some experiment. After that, you people also, we can do some work on lac. Okay. In later on also, you can discuss with me. Once again, thank you, ma'am, Archana ma'am, and Sadhana ma'am, to giving opportunity to share my 10 years experience with you. Okay, I joined INSEE 2010. Now, 10 years is over. I have shared my 10 years experience. Thank you very much. Once again, if you have any doubt, you can ask now also. No problem. Please.
Thank you, sir, for this enlightening session.
I'm sure the informative and precious knowledge you shared have helped the students. Now, I would like to invite the head of the department, Dr. Sadhana Tandon, for the vote of thanks.
Thank you, Nalini. On behalf of faculty and students of PG Department of Zoology, Kanya Mahavidyalaya, I wish to express my deep gratitude and sincere thanks to Dr. Mohan Sundaram for his wonderful and interesting presentation highlighting different aspects of lac culture and for beautifully demonstrating it by showing various specimens and videos. Thank you, sir, for sparing your valuable time to enlighten us all with this interesting topic, that is lac culture. Thanks to all the fellow participants and students for attending this e-workshop and gaining knowledge on this very interesting topic. Thank you once again. Thank you all. Thank you, sir.
Thank you so much, sir.
Thank you very much, madam. From student side, you can ask any question. If you need doubt, any clarification.
Yeah, definitely. Yes. I'll forward. If they have any query, they'll send it to me. I'll forward to you, sir. Definitely.
Definitely, ma'am. Yeah. Thank you very much, ma'am.
Okay.
Thank you. Close. Shall I close?
Yes. Thank you.
Thank you very much, ma'am. Thank you.
Thank you. Ma'am, you can end the meeting.